Today we start the syllabus of class 12 with first unit, and first unit of the syllabus is electrostatics. Electrostatics. Let's try to understand what is the meaning of electrostatics. This electrostatics deals with the study of electric charges at rest, and it is also called static electricity. If we divide electrostatic into two parts, this is statics and now this is electro. Statics means at rest, electro is taken from electric charges, so that it is known as electric charges at rest. Sometimes it is also called frictional electricity. Frictional electricity. Now the question is, what do you mean by charges or electric charges? To understand what is the meaning of electric charge, because you know what is at rest. Now we have to study the electric charges. So we'll perform an experiment. We'll try to understand with the help of the experiment what is the meaning of electric charges. To demonstrate this experiment, to understand the meaning of electric charges, we have few straw. Two straws are there, and there are small bits of pieces of papers. And this is small. Bring this straw near the small bits of paper. Nothing happens. Similarly, when this another straw is brought near small bits of paper, nothing happens. But when this straw is rubbed with this cloth, I am rubbing this with the help of this cloth, and again this straw is brought near small pieces of paper, then thus this straw attracts these small bits of paper. It means the nature of this straw is changed. Let's do it again with the second straw, when it is again rubbed with this shirt. And if it is brought near these small bits of paper, then again it attracts these small bits of paper. It means nature of these two straws is changed. It means earlier this straw was not charged, and now this straw becomes charged or electrified. So this straw as well as this straw is said to be charged or electrified. We'll try to understand it theoretically also. Now let's perform another experiment. Now again charge this straw and put it on this foil gently. I'm trying to place it, it's slightly difficult to adjust it. Now, okay. Another straw which is again rubbed with this side. So this straw is again charged, and when this straw is brought near this small, near this another straw, something happens. And what happens? The first straw is repelled by the second straw. It means there is a repelling force between these two straws. Initially, when these straws are brought near small bits of paper, they attract these small bits of paper. When these two charged straws are brought near with each other, then they repel each other. Now we'll try to understand what happens when this straw is rubbed with the cloth. And this straw is said to be charged. Due to friction, some of the electrons from the straw are transferred to the cloth, or some of the electrons from cloth are transferred to straw. The transfer of electrons from one body to another body gives charge on these bodies. Suppose electrons are transferred from body. body A to body B, then body A will become positively charged and body A will become negatively charged. And this is called frictional electricity because it happens on account of friction between these two bodies. When these two bodies are rubbed with each other, then due to friction, some of the electrons are transferred from body A to B, and this body A is positively charged and B is negatively charged. This is the reason why it is called frictional electricity. But what is the reason behind it? From which body to which body the electrons will be transferred? It can be explained by using a term, work function. Work function. What is the composition of a body? Every body consists of large number of small particles, which are called atoms. Atoms consist of a central core region, which is nucleus. Electrons are revolving around the nucleus into different circular orbits or elliptical orbits. But the energy which is required to liberate the electron from the surface of a substance, which is the minimum energy required to liberate or to escape the electron, just escape the electron from the surface of a substance, is called work function. And it depends on the nature of the substance. ये बिल्कुल nature पे depend करेगा. Some of the substance have smaller value of work function and some other substance have higher value of work function. We can say small amount of energy required to escape the electron from some of the metals, but in some other metals we have to provide large amount of energy to escape the electron from the surface of those substances. So when two bodies are rubbed together, then electrons are transferred from one body to another body, in which when one body has smaller value of work function, so the electron will be transferred from a body at lower work function to another body at higher work function. Because a small amount of energy is required to escape the electron from the body which has lower value or smaller value of work function. Just like we are writing on this board, ink is transferred on the board just because of friction. So this is the reason why electrons are transferred from one body to another body, and this body is said to be electrified. This body is also said to be electrified or charged. Moreover, this experiment shows that there are two types of forces. Earlier, this straw attracts small bits of paper, and in the second part of the experiment, that these two straws